Did you know that almost everything you see on TV or in the movies uses a transition on every single cut, even if they're just audio crossfades? That's a lot of transitions. Today, I want to show you the Blackmagic Design DaVinci Resolve Speed Editor has 5 dedicated keys to help make this process of putting transitions down easier. And I've also got some great keyboard shortcuts and mouse tips to get you going with Resolve 17. Let's check it out. The DaVinci Resolve Speed Editor has 3 buttons right here. These 3 keys, Cut, Dissolve, Smooth Cut, and the right underneath the trimming buttons. But also, if you look at the computer screen in the cut page, we have the same ones over here. We have Cut, Dissolve, and Smooth Cut. So if you don't have the speed editor yet, you can use these buttons and sort of follow along. All right, the first one here that confused me is cut. So cut does not actually split a clip, meaning cut it in half. So if I hit cut, you can see it didn't actually cut the clip. If we go up here, the button you want to use is split if you want to actually cut the clip. I don't know why they didn't call. The terminology is kind of messed up. I'm going to double tap Escape to undo that. It's also, just so you know, this cut has nothing to do with the edit cut button that's up here in the menu for copying and pasting. So just know that. What cut is actually going to do is it's going to strip off any transition that's on your timeline based off of your smart indicator. So this little triangle here is on this dissolve. If I hit cut, it strips it right off. Now that's great and dandy for just one or two at a time. You can strip those off with the cut button. But what if you have like a whole timeline of transitions that you want to replace and do something different with? If you hit Shift 4 to go to the edit page, Command A selects all your clips. And now if you hit the cut button, it takes all those transitions off. So you probably saw right there, there were some other dissolves. That's a really quick way to get rid of lots of transitions. Next, we're going to look at the dissolve button. And a dissolve is a pretty magical thing. It's going to be your most commonly used deal. We're going to hit dissolve, and it's going to fade from one clip to the next. It's going to sort of blend those together really smoothly. Now, a lot of times you're going to use a dissolve. You're going to show like a change in time or location. But one thing that I found really useful that you're going to use all the time is a crossfade. So if you jump to the edit page, I'll show you what I'm talking about. Let's zoom in, Command Plus. And the crossfade is just down there on the audio. And what that's doing is it's making a smooth transition so there's no pops or clicks between the cut. Because in video editing software, if you're unaware, if you make a cut, it's going to make a pop or click because you're going to have a waveform that's not going to cut at a zero crossing. So this is a really quick way to sort of clean those up. However, one thing you notice is it put a cross dissolve on this clip and a crossfade. That is basically how this dissolve button works. If you have linked video and audio and you're in here in the cut page, it's going to do both at the same time. What if you don't want that? Let me show you how to do that. So the way we're going to put a crossfade only and not a dissolve on the picture part is to hit Shift E on the keyboard. Okay, and what that's done is it's sort of highlighted it green down there, you can see. And after the Shift E is sort of selected, we can hit Shift T is going to do a crossfade only. Okay, the reason I did the Shift E first is because it actually gives you a little bit more control, and I'll show you more about that later. To demonstrate Smooth Cut, I want to show you an interview clip real quick, and this is how we're going to be using Smooth Cut.
I met Santino my senior year of high school. And when I first met him, I just completely fell for him.
Okay, we heard that, and I want to get rid of that. That's a really common thing to do when you're editing. Is you're going to cut out the word
We fell for him.
So we could do that by hitting split on the keyboard, and then we could hit. We're going to go to the side here, and we'll hit trim in, and that gets rid of that So if we listen to it again,
completely fell for him. We spent every day.
You see her head kind of shake there. So what Smooth Cut is going to do, or is going to attempt to do, is use optical flow, which is a technology that kind of blends the frames together magically. So we'll hit Smooth Cut. That drops that on there. And it takes a second to render. And the other thing is that Blackmagic suggests that you only use Smooth Cut with a duration of 2 to 4 frames. So we're going to get to this button in a second. But if I hold the duration button here, we can kind of dial in. We're going to say 4 frames. Okay, we're going to say that transition's 4 frames. We'll roll it back here with the search dial. Hit play.
Fell for him. We spent every day.
And it kind of made that cut actually work. So this is one of the times I can count on maybe one single hand that I've ever used Smooth Cut and it worked. I just want to show you that it actually can work, so give it a shot sometime. But it's probably the most useless button on this entire speed editor. So I wish they really hadn't dedicated a whole button to it. But it's there. That's how it works. So use it if you're in a bind and you don't have B-roll to cut to during an interview. Before we move on to the next section, I want to let you know these buttons actually work a little differently with live overwrite, which I have a whole tutorial on setting up a sync bin and doing multicam. And what these are going to let you do, see these little glowing sections here? If I hit live overwrite, we have an option now. Dissolve is glowing in red. We can actually paint on a clip with a dissolve. And the way that works is if that's selected, and we go back to our timeline and paint a new clip on, so I'll just hit play.
The first time we met, we went rock climbing. Well, we tried to go rock climbing.
She says, well, we tried to go rock climbing. What if we want to cut to angle 2 with a dissolve? I'm just going to pull this back, and then... And I've just hit cam 2 button, and while I held that down, you can see it actually dropped a clip down there with a dissolve. Hit timeline to review it.
That didn't happen.
So that's one way you can use it. It's not really my preference at all to be adding a dissolve when you're doing a multicam, but it can be done, and that's kind of what that's there for and how you could use it. Now that you know about cut, dissolve, and smooth cut using the speed editor, I've got a tip using the mouse to create transitions that you may have never seen before. So about everybody knows you can modify a transition by clicking and dragging with your mouse, but what a lot of people don't know, if we hit cut right here, is just using your mouse, you can select a clip and you can hold Option Shift on the keyboard, click and drag, and it automatically creates a new crossfade for you. So that's a nice little mouse trick. You just click to select a clip, Option Shift, and drag, and that creates a crossfade on the audio and a dissolve on the video for you. Pretty slick. Speaking of the mouse, why was the mouse afraid of the speed editor? Because the search dial has cat-like reflexes. So we are cruising along, and the next button on the speed editor I want to show you is transition duration and set. So transition duration, the way this is going to work is it's going to set how long the duration is on your cut that you're dropping. So if you hold it down and then you grab the search dial and move that, it's going to make it longer and shorter. So the bonus tip, or the extra little magic sauce that happens with the set button here, is once you drop that down, and we have this set now, I'm going to roll it to exactly 1 second. Once that's set, if you double tap, that has set a new default that every single time I put down a new dissolve or transition, it's going to put it to that exact length. So let's go to another section, and why don't we drop one right here's a section where it could use one. Let's put a dissolve there, and we can see it put that to exactly 1 second. And we know that because if we hold transition duration again and start to scroll it, it was 1 second. The fifth button I want to show you on the speed editor for transitions is the trans/title button, which is right up here. And the way this is actually going to work, you can use it to modify or add a transition that's not a cut, dissolve, or smooth cut, as long as it's not one of these brand new, at the bottom they have these fusion transitions. As long as it's not a fusion transition, you can edit it right there with that button. So we're going to do that. We're going to hold this down, so it's a tap hold. And when you do that, it gives you all the options in the world. It's a lot of stuff you probably won't use very often, but it's still a lot of fun to be able to use with the search dial. So let's choose barn door, we'll release it, and we can see the barn door transition has been applied. And it's also, if you notice from our last tip, this has been set to the 1 second duration that we had preset as a sort of our transition length that we want to be using. So if I wanted to make that shorter again and go back to that, let's make it a real fast, like 12 second. So it's like a half second one, and double tap. That gets us a real quick wipe as it goes into that next shot. So, and it's super easy to go back and change it to a different type of transition. If you don't like that one, you just hold transition down, use the search dial, and you can choose any one of these incredible transitions, including my favorite, start wipe. Let's check it out. Magical. Quickly, I want to call a timeout and say welcome if you're new here. My name is Chadwick. This is Creative Video Tips, where I help you create videos that make a difference and stand out. If that's something you're into and you haven't already done so, click subscribe right down below so you don't miss out on the tip next week. Now with that out of the way, let's jump back into Resolve, because I've got some great keyboard shortcuts that are going to help you out with transitions to speed up your editing in the edit page. So to get to the edit page, we're going to be hitting Shift 4. That takes us over there, and we need to drop a transition on here to begin with. We'll use the speed editor. We'll hit Dissolve. Okay. And when we did that, one thing to note, and I would suggest you set up in Resolve, is to change your crossfade audio type. By default, we can see over here in the Spectre, it is set to crossfade 0 dB. That's not great. We want to change that actually. And so we're going to hit cut to remove the transition. We're going to change that over here in our, if you go to your effects library, audio transitions, we have Crossfade plus 3 dB. This is the one you're going to want to use most of the time. Don't ask me why, just set a standard transition and you're going to be super happy. But what I want to do now is actually just put those plus 3 dB crossfades on every single clip to get rid of those pops and clicks. The way we're going to do that is with the command Shift T. By hitting Shift T, we can see we just put crossfades on every single clip down there in the timeline. And so that's just going to smooth things out and get rid of any pops and clicks. And so here are my next four favorite keyboard shortcuts. We're gonna hit V, and the way I use V is for VIN betweens, because it's gonna go VIN between the clips. And then we're gonna be hitting U to cycle the side of the clip that we're actually selected. So you can see right here, we're on the left side only, but if we use U, which I call other side, like other, we're gonna tap U and that cycles between them. So right here, we're selecting both the left and the right of the clip, and here we're selecting the right side only, okay? We'll tap it one more time, or two more times, we'll be in the middle. And then the next one is T for transition. So we have V for VIN between, U to cycle the other side, and then T is gonna be a transition. We're gonna be dropping a transition with Command T. Okay, that's gonna be putting them on both at the same time, both the video and the audio. I'm gonna hit Command Z to undo. Or you could do Shift T, which we've talked about, which just does the audio section only. Command T to undo that. Or guess what else we got? Option T does just the video side. My final keyboard shortcut, I wanna make sure I show you, because if you watched my trimming video, I showed you a way that was probably more complicated than needed to be to do a J or L cut with the speed editor. So what we're gonna be doing is using Option E, okay? Option E is gonna select the video track, and once that is selected, you can just hit roll on the speed editor, hold it down, and then move it, and you have a J or L cut. The other thing is, if you haven't seen that video, that's a big limitation in the cut page over here. Shift 3 is you cannot do a J or L cut when you're in this page. Now we're going to take a look at using the transitions browser to add transitions to a lot of clips at once. So here we are in the cut page. We can see we've got all the clips. We're going to hit Command A to select them all. And if we want to apply the same transitions to all the clips at once, one way to do that is if you go to the transition browser, and let's say we want to be putting an iris on everything, you could right click here and say it is called add to selected edit points and clips. And we can see we have now added that to every single transition to make the most amazing video of lots of irises. You could see there's probably a lot better uses for this, maybe if it's a slideshow or something, but that is how that's done. Now, if we just want to add a transition to one of them using the mouse, we're going to select all of these and we're going to hit cut to remove our transitions. Hopefully you've learned that one by now. And we can just go to any edit point with the search dial that we want to be adding a transition, and we can say it's just a simple click and drag of that transition. And it can be dragged to the top timeline here, or it could be dragged down here. These both work in the cut page. So if you're unfamiliar with that, they are working together at the same time. So one thing I want to make sure you understand about transitions is they need handles. And a handle basically is the part that you've already trimmed out on the timeline. A transition will use that part to smooth things out. So if you run out of handles, let me show you what it looks like. We're going to be removing this cut that's right there, and we'll go ahead and trim this shot all the way out till it gets to the red point. And why don't we go and take the other side, we'll hit trim on this one and extend it till it's red. So if we look at these two clips right now, we cannot trim either side, right? If we trim in or trim out, that's red. And so what's going to happen when we try to put a transition on this is it flashes if we hit the dissolve button on here. If we take one from over here, let's do something different. How about arrow iris on this one? We're gonna click and drag that down there. It doesn't even do anything. What happens if we right click it and we say, I wanna say add to selected edit points and clips. It gives us this error. We can say trim clips or skip clips. If we choose trim clips, it's basically taking the same amount from both sides to apply it. I'm gonna hit undo to undo that. And the other option here is gonna be, if we say add to selected clips and we choose skip clips, That's useful if you have multiple clips selected and it's just kind of going down in a row if there's no handles available.
If you learned at least one thing in this video, please make sure to give it a like. And if you want to learn more about DaVinci Resolve, the speed editor, there's a playlist popping up right over here right now. And I've got all kinds of tips on using multicam, the search style, cut page, edit page, trimming. There is so much to learn. So I'll see you over in that next video.